We're going to welcome a lady now who really has helped us over the last few years to start managing our pennies. They're literally only pennies now. So let's say good morning to Crystal Howell and see how she's going to help us. I think we've talked this into existence. You've been talking about managing our pennies all this time. And when we were saying that, I had dollar bills. Now I literally have. How are you, Crystal?
It's I have to say, she's on a roll today because I was cracking up at the wrong. I don't think Cassandra fully appreciated it, but I was cracking up.
Right? I didn't, Crystal, but you know what? Lynn did too. Lynn messaged me and said, Tatisha, I love her. That wall was good. There you go.
That was so good.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Not to manage any pennies. I love a Cardi joke, sorry. But
You
yeah.
see?
Here's your
All
sister.
right.
Now, so you can kind of catch your breath. If it's any consolation, a friend messaged me and he said, I went out for a run, so I burned calories, not brownies.
It goes on. It goes on. He was closer to my thinking.
No.
Yeah.
Yes.
Anyway,
Yes.
before we burn
Not
these
how
minutes
schedule.
for this conversation
Yes.
here, let's focus on managing this money here, these pennies.
So we're actually wrapping up the segment where we've been discussing, thanks to our friends, chartered professional accountants, how we will be discussing money and finances with children. And I think by now, hopefully, people have as many tips as possible. And this last segment is going to be talking about virtual money. And it's something that is going to become more and more popular as we go along because of many of the advantages people find with working with virtual money. And I know we do have some forms of virtual currency here, as well as online transactions and forms of currency that we would use. But there's a whole world of ways that we could spend money online, including Amazon and e-commerce. There are persons who are doing transactions online with their bank accounts. I know that has increased exponentially for me since we've had our curfews and everything else. It's a lot more convenient to be able to transfer money to persons online rather than going to an ATM withdrawing funds, especially with the bank lines being so long now because of the curfews and when we had the alphabet system and everything else. It is much more convenient. But do we explain to our children how they would do these things? Or is this just another thing that we leave for when they're adults to figure out on their own? So one of the first things I will get into is doing online transactions where many of our local banks will actually facilitate the use of being able to transfer money from one bank account to another and being able to pay vendors and to pay bills online. And I could tell you, I don't know for yourself, but I know for me, that has been invaluable in being able to cut down on time, to be able to cut down on risks in terms of exposure to the COVID-19. And just the convenience of it altogether. And many times, most of those transactions are free. So, for persons who may be a personal bank account where you're transferring from one bank account to another or paying a bill, it's actually free. So, you reduce your physical risk and exposure to COVID-19, and you do it all from the comfort of your home for free.
Yeah, and I think
Excellent.
what needs to be paramount is security, because now that you're doing e-commerce and m-commerce, which really is just commerce on your mobile phone, etc., you really need to feel that it's secure. So you really need to put things in place like those two-step authentication
Yeah.
initiatives and so on in place. So, what would be your advice for those people who, they're slowly getting there, pushed in a big way because of what was happening with COVID-19, but who still have some reservations?
I would say always exercise extreme caution, even for those persons who are used to it. There's always some kind of phishing scam to try to get you to engage in an online transaction that's actually fraudulent. So you always need to be aware. If you see an email that is coming to you from your financial institution that is out of the norm and it seems as though something might be off, there's nothing wrong with contacting your financial institution to make sure that it's legitimate. And teach your children to do these things as well. Teach them to keep their financial information confidential, not to share their PINs when they're using their credit cards without having any kind of legitimate transaction with some person that you know for sure on the other end is a legitimate person. So if you've contacted the bank, if you have contacted that person, not the person initiating that transaction with you, and you're not sure if you're speaking to a representative of that financial institution, make sure you protect all your documents, your passwords, your PINs, and keep them in a safe location. I know it's hard sometimes to keep track of everything, but make sure that you have it in a location that cannot be easily hacked or acquired by the wrong persons. You want to make sure they're aware of all of these precautions. As you mentioned, the two-step authentication, all of these things are important. And if you do feel as though you're a little lost, there's nothing wrong with reaching out to some person that you trust or to some, one of the persons at the same financial institutions to have them walk you through how to do it properly. There are a lot of persons, because they know the environment that we're in right now, they have actually been a lot more sympathetic to being able to explain to persons and walking them through how to use these transactions. So whether you're online buying something from Amazon or you're using your credit card, take all precautions. It's as much precautions as you would take with your physical cash.
Mm-hmm. Is there a right age to start introducing children to the online process? Because you want to be confident as well that they're responsible enough and they have the know-how for navigating all those things that we've just been discussing. So is there a right age?
I won't put a particular age because everybody's child is different. Some children that from 5 years old, you can trust them alone with certain responsibilities, and there are others that you wait till much older. But I would say, I would encourage persons to do it from as young as possible. There are children in primary school who understand money very well, and they pick up on these things a lot faster than we do. I strongly encourage you to do it from as early as possible. And you don't have to throw the entire education onto them from the get-go. You do it in bits and pieces. And as you see how they take on to that understanding with a small bit, you then expose them to a little more and a little more until they have the full picture. Take them with you. When you're going online, show them exactly what it is that you do and walk through it. Explain every part. Explain why this part is important to keep secret and confidential. Explain to them how you actually set up a vendor in your bank account so that you can pay them. Emphasize the importance of making sure that you confirm that everything is accurate, because you don't want that you send money accidentally to the wrong account. Walk through everything with them and all the risks so that they're fully aware and they get comfortable, as opposed to being adults that are very timid and afraid to do these things. And we know this is a reality in Barbados.
Right.
Absolutely. And, you know, I can agree totally. Sorry, Cassandra, you proceed.
Yeah. It's okay. I actually wanted to just ask you for a follow-on question there. We're having the conversation with them too about who they accept money from. How important is that?
That is very, very, very important, because you do not want children to feel as though is the same way you would not feel comfortable with your child accepting physical cash from a stranger or from a strange source. It's the same thing with online money. And there are persons who are using these scams to be able to lure your children into nefarious activities or schemes. And you want to make sure that your child is fully aware. And people are afraid because it's online, but the danger is just as present for physical interactions as it is for online ones. It's just that we have fully ventilated what they should be aware of when it comes to physical dangers. we have to take that much precautions when it comes to online dangers.
Excellent.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Crystal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bar sharing my password, I think I will definitely get the little one because she probably would go shopping.
Yes. Yes. We don't want the child to go now and be swiping and buying up a storm on behalf of your credit card. That would not be good.
Responsibility.
Want to teach a responsibility and consequences, because I could tell you, if I had a child and my child did that, the world of consequences that would come down.
Yeah. Thank you.
We say that until such time.
As always. Thank you so much.